Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're continuing our work on direct proportion. So, I just want you to remember, if you can, from the previous videos, what is direct proportion? What does it mean if two quantities are in direct proportion? Two quantities are in direct proportion or are directly proportional, then we know the following is true. As one of the quantities increases, the other increases at the same rate. Or if one of the quantities decreases, the other quantity decreases at the same rate. Now, I also need you to practice a skill we did in the last video. I want you to pause the video and double check you could do the following. Well, I showed you in the last video how to do it using a ratio or a double number line. Imagine you did have a double number line, your kilometers and miles like that. Well, you know that 8 kilometers is worth 5 miles. That was your double number line there. And you're trying to work out what 1 mile is worth. So you want 1 mile down here. How do you get from 5 to 1? You divide by 5. So that's exactly what you're going to have to do here. You're going to also have to do 8 divided by 5, and you'll get yourself 1.6. And that's how I showed you to do it on that way. I also showed you how to do it with ratios, and I said that's the way to always do it. So I said always write down 1 kilometer to 5 miles, your rate, and I said do it in ratio form. You want to convert 1 mile to kilometers, so you want this number to be 1 mile, and you'd have to divide by 5, and similarly here you'd have to divide by 5, and like I got above 1.6 kilometers. Now this is how I said you're going to do it henceforth, because you can't really be drawing number lines your whole life. Now what if I asked you though the following question? Convert 7.6 miles to kilometers. Can you ever think about how on earth you do that? Well, before I show you how to do it in the ratio way, I want to show you something else. So I want you to go back up to the double number line up here, right? And I want you to realize that from step one, didn't we do this? From the first step, we worked out that 1 mile, okay, was equal to 1.6 kilometers. I worked that out. And this here is a rate of conversion, and it's the unit rate. It's the unit rate. So that means it's what 1 mile is worth. 1 mile is 1.6 kilometers. Now, from that there, this could be the key to us working out what 7.6 miles is. Because 7.6 miles is somewhere here. How would I get from the 1, the unit rate, to 7.6? Well, I'd multiply by 7.6, wouldn't I? So what would I have to do to this number? Well, I'd multiply by 7.6, and I'd get 12.16. So I know 7.6 miles is 12.16, which is absolutely great. Now, that's how it works on this picture. So I have to work out my unit rate, like I did in the first one. I scale back, I divide by 5 to get the unit rate, and then I multiply by 7.6 to get the rate, the value I want. Now, how would I do this with my ratios? Well, what I'd do is I'd do what I always did. I would start off by writing 8 kilometers to 5 miles. I know I eventually want to get to 7.6 miles, right? So I'm going to leave a gap. That's what I'm trying to do, get the kilometers there. Now, because I can't obviously, I don't know how to scale from 5 to 7.6, obviously, I would first scale down to 1 mile, the unit rate, by dividing by 5, and I would divide this by 5 as well to get myself exactly as I got before. But having got what 1 mile's worth, I can multiply by 7.6, and I can multiply this by 7.6, just like I did up here, and I would get myself 12.16 kilometers. And this is the method we're going to use henceforth. So now we should have enough skills to do this video. Let's go and have a go at some questions. Pause the video, have a go at these. Okay, 8 kilometers is 5 miles, so I always write that down. I want to work out 15.3 miles. So I'm going to go over here and I'm going to say, right, I want 15.3 miles, right? And I want to work out how many kilometers that is. It's not obvious how to scale from 5 to 15.3. So I'm going to do an intermediary step. I'm going to first work out what 1 mile is worth. So I'm going to divide both sides by 5. I know how to do that because I did that on the last slide. So that's 1.6 kilometers to 1 mile. And from now, it's easy to scale up from 1 mile to 15.3 miles. I multiply by 15.3. So I'm going to multiply 1.6 by 15.3 as well. Now, assume you've either got time to work that out or you've got a calculator, but you would get yourself 24.48 kilometers and you're done. Right, what about this one? Or we'll start off with the same method. Now we want to get ourselves to 32.7 kilometers. So this time I'm going to write 32.7 on the kilometers side of this ratio. It's not obvious how to scale up from 8 to that, so I'm going to do it in steps. I'm first going to work out what 1 kilometer is worth by dividing by 8, and I'll do that divided by 8, and I'll get myself 5 divided by 8 is equal to 0.625 miles. Now, happy days from here, we can easily scale up from this point. I'm going to multiply by 32.7, and on this side here, I'm going to multiply by 32.7. So if I do that, I get myself 20.4375 miles. All right, and that's how I would have done it. Next question, pause the video, have a go. Always write your rate down to start these questions. So I'm going to write over here that I want £18.50. I want to work out how many euros that is. It's not obvious how to scale up, so I'm first going to scale down to £1 by dividing by 3. So I'm also going to do that this side by dividing by 3. And I'm going to get myself, I'm going to leave it as fraction for now because that's not my final answer. And then in order to scale up, I'm going to multiply by £18.50. So I'm going to multiply this side by £18.50 as well, or 18.5. So 4/3 multiplied by 18.5, you would get yourself 24.6 recurring. So I'm going to get myself 24.6 recurring euros. Now, you have to give your answer to two decimal places, and we should state it at the end. So £18.50 is, now think about 24.6, that's 24.6 recurring would be 6666 like that. So if you're going to round that to two decimal places, it's going to be 24 euros 67, like that, and we're done. The one on the other side, exactly the same thing. You say 4 euros to £3. You want to get yourself 24 euros 60 in this case. So we're going to do two steps. We're going to scale down to 1 euro by dividing both sides by 4. And that would get me 75 pence or 0.75 pounds. And then we're going to scale up here by multiplying by 24.60, and if I do that on the other side, £18.45, and there you go, you have done your conversion. Next question, pause the video, have a go. Okay, you can solve this one using ratios, assuming that price per egg is a constant rate. Okay, so it says a shop sells 6 eggs for £2.16. How much would 17 eggs cost? Assuming that the number of eggs and the price are directly proportional, you could solve this. So you could say, now you want 17 eggs, so we'd probably do it in two stages. What we'd do is we'd first scale down to 1 egg, so we'd divide by 6 to get 1 egg. So we'd have to divide both of these by 6, and if you do £2.16 divided by 6, you get yourself 36 pence. So each egg is 36 pence, and from that point you would scale up to 17 eggs by multiplying both sides by 17. And if you multiplied both sides by 17, you would get yourself that the 17 eggs should cost you £6.12, and you're done. Okay, last question, pause the video, have a go. Right, here we're told that for every 10 litres of petrol the car can run for 75 kilometres, it says how much petrol do you need to one decimal place to ensure the car has enough for a trip that is 113 kilometres. So let's write our rate. We know that 10 litres gets us 75 kilometres in the car. These two are proportional to each other because as your litres goes up, your how far your car can go goes up by the same ratio or rate. So we want to work out how much petrol you need for 113 kilometers. It's not obvious how to scale up from 75 to 113. So let's first work out the unit rate. Let's work out how much petrol you need for 1 kilometer. So we're going to divide both sides by 75. Now when you do 10 divided by 75 on your calculator, 10 divided by 75, it tells you as a decimal is 0.13 recurrent. It is best to just at this stage, because you're going to use that answer. Leave it as an exact fraction right now, and we'll do all our rounding at the very end, all right? Don't round in the middle, round at the end. Now we're going to multiply both sides by 113 to scale up to see how much you need for 113 kilometers, and 2 over 15, 2/15 multiplied by 113 gets us the answer 15.06 liters recurring. Now it asked us to give our answer to one decimal place, so we should state it at the end. Therefore we need, if we round this to one decimal place, 15.1 liters. And that will certainly bring us the distance we want. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.